Hello students, welcome to our video number 15 of Fundamentals of Partnership Accounts. So far we have studied about profit and loss appropriation account, partners capital accounts, calculation and treatment of various items of adjustments when treated as appropriation, when treated as charge. Then we learned about past adjustments and then guarantee of profits to a partner. In some cases, if we find that a partner gives guarantee to other partners that the firm will not earn an amount of profit less than this amount, then this is known as guarantee of minimum profit by a partner to the firm. So today's topic is how to deal with such type of guarantee. When a partner guarantees the firm minimum profit or minimum amount of earning, how to treat that while preparing profit and loss appropriation? Suppose there are three partners, A, B and C. They both have started partnership firm newly. Suppose they have newly started a partnership firm. C, an experienced one, he says that in this partnership firm, because of me, the firm will earn a profit of minimum 1 lakh rupees at the end of the year. Now, after the end of the year, profits were calculated, and as for the effort of C, the amount of profit earned by the firm was 80,000 rupees. It means there was a shortage of 20,000 rupees from the amount guaranteed by C to the firm. So this 20,000 rupees is the shortfall of profits. So this 20,000 rupees will be taken from C and the total profits will be then calculated. Out of these total profits, adjustments will be made. After making the adjustments, the divisible profit will be distributed to the partners. And here in this case also, along with this guarantee by a partner to the firm, if any individual partner is also given a guarantee of minimum profits, that will be executed as what we learned in our previous classes. Try to understand it again. If a partner gives a guarantee that firm will not earn an amount of profit less than a said amount. If the firm earns lesser amount of profit than that guaranteed amount, then the difference, the shortfall of these profits will be taken from that guaranteeing partner. And the total profit of the firm will be taken as those guaranteed profits. This will be then calculated as divisible profit, and remaining, we know how to execute individual partners' guarantee. So for this, profit and loss appropriation form will be prepared. We will transfer the amount of profit actually earned by the firm from the profit and loss account. If it is less than the amount guaranteed to the firm by a partner, then the difference, that shortage amount, we will take from that partner. Say, here C has given a guarantee in our case. So we write it by C's capital account. Say the amount of profit of the firm were 1 lakh rupees and it is falling short of 20,000 rupees on account of C. So 20,000 we take from C. Total profits number 1,20,000 rupees. Then on the debit side, we will make necessary adjustments, and from those adjustments, whatever amount is remaining as individual profit, we will distribute that to the partners. So this is how we execute the amount of guarantee to the firm of minimum profits by a partner. Got it? So let us do it with the help of a cluster.
Three lawyers, L, M and N, form a partnership with capitals of 6 lakh rupees, 5 lakh rupees and 4 lakh rupees respectively, subject to the following conditions. We will share profits and losses in the ratio of 2:2:1. Partners are entitled to interest on capital at 10% per annum. N's share of profit is guaranteed to be not less than 1,50,000 rupees per annum. M gives a guarantee to the effect that the total fee earned by him for the firm will not be less than 2,50,000 rupees. So here M has given a guarantee to the firm and N has been given guarantee by the firm. Profit of the firm for the first year ended 31st March 2020 is 810,000 rupees. That is 8,10,000 rupees. The total fee earned by M for the firm is 1,60,000 rupees. Whereas M has given a guarantee to the firm of 2,50,000 rupees and he has earned only 1,60,000 rupees. So the amount which he is of shortfall here will be covered from him. It will be recovered from him. Prepare profit and loss appropriation account after giving effect to the above. So let's solve this question.
So in this question, we have to prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Once again, I tell you about the question. There are three partners, L, M, N, N. So we write here L, M, N, N. Three partners are there, the capital amount is given. So we write here the capital amount 6 lakh, then 5 lakhs, then 4 lakhs. The profit sharing ratio is given 2:2:1. This is the profit sharing ratio. Interest on capital is to be allowed to them at 10%. So 6 lakh is capital, 10% of that is 60,000 for L, 50,000 for N, and 40,000 is for N. This is their interest on capital. Then N is guaranteed a profit of not less than 1,50,000 rupees, and M has given a guarantee to the firm that total fee earned by him for the firm will be not less than 2,50,000 rupees. M, a partner, has given guarantee to the firm here that his fee earned for the firm will not be less than 2,50,000 rupees, in which he has given guarantee to the firm. This is the topic. So let us see how much he earned for the firm. Profit of the firm for the year of 8,10,000 rupees. This is the amount of profit. So this amount of profit is 8,10,000 rupees. Let us see how much N, this M earned. So M earned 1,60,000 rupees. M earned 1,60,000 rupees. And what amount of profits he guaranteed? He guaranteed 2,50,000 rupees. It means there is a shortfall from his side. So we will take 90,000 rupees. The difference, he guaranteed 2,50,000 rupees and he actually earned only 1,60,000 rupees for the firm. So 90,000 rupees first we will take from him. Then that we will subtract, we will add the amount of profit and total amount of profit. That will be our projected profits of the firm. That projected amount of profit will be distributed to the partners. So here, firm's profit of the firm are 8,10,000 plus shortage or shortfall covered or recovered from M. M guaranteed 2,50,000 rupees, but he earned only 1,60,000 rupees. We add it and it becomes 9 lakh rupees. Now this 9 lakh rupees will be distributed to these partners. So share the profit to N. The actual share of profits to N. N has been given a guarantee. So for N we will calculate. Out of 9 lakh, we subtract interest on capital minus interest on capital. 60 plus 50, 110 plus 40, 150. So 1,50,000 we subtract from it into N's share is 1/5. This is N's actual sharing profits before guarantee, without guarantee. That means so 9 lakh minus 150 is 7,50,000 into 1/5. So So 750 upon 5. It is 5 into 5, 5, 5 to 25. So 15. That means 150,000 is his share, actual share. Now he has been guaranteed a profit of 150,000. That means there is no deficiency on his account. He has been guaranteed 150,000 rupees, and 150,000 rupees he is getting here. So there is no deficiency on his account. Minus it is shown here, guaranteed profits to him. So it is 150,000 rupees subtract, then deficiency will be here in name. So no deficiency. Right? We will calculate it now. We will prepare the profit loss account now. We write it first by profit and loss account. Net profit, as per the profit loss account, it is 810,000. Then what we have covered up from M, because he guaranteed that he will earn 250,000 rupees for the account, but he earned only 160,000 rupees. So here we write by M's capital account. How much? 90,000 rupees. Try to understand it again. M guaranteed to the firm that he will earn 250,000 rupees, but he earned only 160,000 rupees for the firm. It means 90,000 rupees is the amount of shortfall of profit from his side. Okay? This shortfall of profits we will take from him. So for taking it from him, we debit his capital account. So we have written here as by M's capital account. Right? Now we will make the adjustments. One adjustment is there, we give that to interest on capital. To invest on capital to L, M, M, M. We have already calculated in our notes, working notes there. 60,000 for L, 50,000 for M, and 40,000 rupees for N. So 60 plus 40, 1 lakh plus 50, 1 lakh, 50,000 rupees. Now what is the divisible profit? Total is 8 lakh, 10,000 plus 90, 9 lakh rupees. This 9 lakh rupees we will write. We will subtract from this 9 lakh rupees this 1 lakh 50,000 rupees of interest on capital. Then the remaining amount we will divide to the partners. We will divide among the partners. So it is 750,000 into 2 by 5 for L. We are calculating. So 5, when the 5, 2, 5, 5, 25. So it is 3 lakh rupees for L. 3 will be for M, and it will be 150,000 rupees for N. And N has been guaranteed that he should not get less than 150,000 rupees, and here he is getting 150,000 rupees. So no deficiency on his account. So here we show two partners' capital accounts. L, M, N, N. So simply we will show there is nothing to be done. This 3 lakh rupees to L, 3 to M, and 1 lakh rupees to N. 750, and then we will take the total of both the sides. It's 9 lakhs. So this is our solution. This way we prepare such type of a question when firm has given guarantee by a partner. Okay. We meet again in our next video with valuation of goodwill chapter. So our goodwill we will learn in that. Till then, keep doing the questions. Thank you very much.